Linda, and welcome to Mr. Dear Linda Day 42. As you can see, Julian wants to be your good friend and he's a lovely, lovely person. Goss of the day, Grace went to the zoo with Natalie today and we'll be showing some of that in the Clontarf segment later. I was getting on this bus, right? I was getting the bus back from Johnny's office to my house and not only had I lost my purse, but I was only getting one bus journey, so I figured, okay, I'll pay for this and change. So there was a guy standing at the bus stop and he looked like he was in business suit and I was like, he totally has a bus card, he doesn't know how much the bus is. But then I heard some change in it. So I was like, hey, do you happen to know what the fare for the bus is? And he was like, where are you going? And I was like, going to Dollymount. And he was like, where in Dollymount? And I was like, Dollymount Avenue. And he was like, sure, getting to the bottom of Dollymount Avenue would be 1:15. And I was thinking, he's totally going to see me get off at the top of Dollymount Avenue. So he didn't think I knew where I was going. Because I was like, hey, how much is it to Dollymount? So I was like, oh, I'll be going to the top of Dollymount Avenue. And he was like, oh, that'll be 1:60. And he's like, you're better off getting off at the bottom and walking up. And I was like, oh, but I think I should get off at the top because I've been given directions from the top of Dollymount Avenue because I didn't want him thinking like I'd be horribly lazy. So he said, well, I guess you'll have to pay 1:60 then. And I was like, I guess I will. He was just like being friendly and he was like, so where are you from? And I don't know, I just had to come up with it on the spot. I was like, oh, well, I usually live in Blackrock. But I come to Clontarf a lot, but I usually have a bus ticket with me. I was like, Jesus, I just came up with an entire backstory for my lie. And I sat down on the bus and he was there and sure, he was chatting with the bus man like crazy. And then another bus driver came along and he was chatting with him. And I was like, you're totally part of the bus drivers. You're in with them. And I think he was full on was just like, he knew exactly what he was saying when he was like, you're better off getting to the bottom. So that was my elaborate lie. And then I felt bad for lying. But then karma got me, right? Because there was this man sitting in front of me and he had disgusting toes, right? I looked at his toes and he was an old man and he had really horrible toes. Like his nails were like yellow and falling off. And I was like, oh dear. I was like, oh God. And then I was like, sure, that's grand. You know, older men have toes like that. It's fine. But I looked at them again and I was like, oh God, I'm going to get sick. And suddenly, for the first time ever in my life, this emotion brought on asthma so quickly. My lungs closed up and next thing I know, I'm like disgusting and I go, and I couldn't breathe. And I was like, oh God, oh God. And I had to look away from them, I ignored them for ages. But then later I caught a look at them again. And again, I stopped being able to breathe and my lungs closed up and I was like, so it was just from the sight of these toes, I started not being able to breathe. So that's the goss of the day. And now we'll go over to news of the day. Yay! Okay, Linda, so the news is that George Clooney is apparently maybe secretly getting married to your one here. And they don't know for sure, but they think he's having a secret wedding on Thursday. And it's very sad for us ladies, all the single ladies. And now we'll go over to my interview of the day.
Thanks, Evelyn. We're here in Alice. I have an interview now. So what's the news of the day?
Well, I guess the news of the day would be there was this Ready Steady Bake Off, Team Diskin versus Team Grevelith. And what's the winner get again? Some sort of
toffee-based goods.
Toffee-based
goods. Who are you rooting for?
Team Diskin, of course.
Well, that answers that question.
Oh, he has no opinion of his own. Oh. And what's the goss?
The goss. Just ate an entire bowl of chocolate.
Oh, that's... Yeah. We've tried that once before. That one didn't end very well.
Very nice chocolate.
Over to you at the studio.
And we're back, thank you. Okay, and now we'll go over to our music segment where we'll be playing some Clontarf stuff where we're baking and whatnot. And we'll just be playing Paris today because we've run out of Birmingham footage. Goodbye.
Jesus.